So the next one is Goodwood from Goodwood Festival of Speed, I guess. It's a real track, but I don't know it that much. I don't think it's that popular to be in other racing games. And I cannot think about any real life racing series using that track in the calendar. So again, a double check. ABS is off, traction control off, 100-100. Car is ready, let's try it. Ah, that's the one with the chicane. Nice sunset. Or maybe it's sunrise. Who knows? Quite risky that was. But it paid off. It's 7 laps, so I guess that's the track is quite short. Okay, crazy mistake. But it's definitely first gear that chicane, even though AI starts in the second gear. No, I cannot go full throttle here. I was curious if it's possible. Third gear is actually fine, just not all in. Actually, I think the second gear is a good option for the chicane, and first gear is unnecessary. That car is fast. I and all three are just in front of me. A bit crazy here. Don't see anything. He had a bit messy exit in the Ferrari, but I think he's got a better acceleration. And here's the inside as well. Okay, somehow I managed to stand the track here. Good. There were two guys in one corner. To go, P1. They're catching up really quickly. They gain the boost again every single time. So predictable. Oh, this is final lap. Why won't mess it up? This should be a win. That Ferrari is so close, just behind me. But I don't think there is enough space here to overtake. Yep. That's the win. .7 seconds. Wasn't clean, unfortunately, so no bonus. Okay, next race. Street is Brands Hatch. We're staying in England, then we're moving to Belgium, and to the United States of America, and then to Spain. Same car, same old, same settings. No helps, no ABS, no traction control. Car is at 100-100, so no additional advantage. third gear. Quite busy in that corner. Almost a traffic jam. A drag race. Seven, 17 seconds to the first one, and it's a 6-lap race. Let's see how it goes. Only corner I'm using first gear on. Okay, left him enough space. That was too wide, was nicely done. Sometimes AI positioning is so hard to guess. I'm not sure where they will be on the track, so I can position my car in a place where it will be easier to overtake. But that Ferrari is quite slow at the moment. As soon as I'll overtake him, he gets a boost and the race starts. There we go. That upshift to fourth gear was unnecessary. Maybe they will... interesting. I thought that maybe they only get the boost on the Fantasy trucks, but I remember them getting the boost on the De La Sarte or Le Mans. Definitely is driving without a boost this time. That was the accidental upshift to the fourth gear rather than the downshift to the second. Oh, that's the final lap as well, great. That was a quick one. Back to Dirt Rally 2.0, I guess. Okay, a real circuit, Brands Hatch, and it's already so much more enjoyable. Oh, and it's a clean race as well. And for level 43, 7 more to go to level 50. And a trophy. Okay, next one. Belgium. Spa-Francorchamps. Circuit the Spa-Francorchamps. Okay, let's go. 5 laps, and it's a bit longer racetrack as well, so that will be a longer race. I'm expecting 1 minute 50 lap time, no, maybe more, 2 minutes lap time. They're fast cars. We'll see. Okay. That was horrible. think I picked up the right side here. Ferrari messed up there big time. That Ford is all over the truck as well. Sliding quite a lot. I was braking as hard as I could. And I actually thought there was enough space for me. I was just a small touch though. Okay, I think I'm catching up with the first two Jaguars. XJ13s, I think they are. And that is on the end, in the end of the lap 2. That's the P1, and now it's P2. A Rouge. I think one of those next to corners, I'm not sure if this is the next right-hander, this one, or the next one, is called No Name Corner. They didn't give it a name actually, which I think is quite unusual for racing trucks. Laps to go. 22. Not bad, not bad, I guess. I could probably do much better time driving on puddles and with ABS. But where is the fun in this? Second advantage over second. Quite a big and safe advantage now of almost 7 seconds. Getting close to the end of lap 4. Final lap. Fastest lap by 2 seconds, good. Lock the wheels. The braking zone to T1. Miss shift. Release the clutch too early. 13, almost 14 seconds advantage, which is a huge one, the biggest they had in that series. Seconds advantage, and that's fastest lap. A nice touch. And that's another race in that Nostalgia 1779 series. That car is actually 67. But it wasn't a clean race, unfortunately. What a shame. No bonus for me. And it's quite a big bonus, 50% lost there. So I've got two more races to go. Laguna Seca, so we're going to America. California, sunny California. It was sunny London today as well, so... I can simulate that heat and humidity. Okay, a quick check, nothing should have changed since last time. No, it's still ABS off, 100-100 and traction control off. Actually, I should have finished that for credits and for experience. My mistake. Jaguar and something slower than the two of them. That was a nice maneuver. That Ferrari went wide and overtook that Jag. He was quite slow in that corner. Too deep into that apex. Quite a big bump on that curb. That was good. I was a bit too late on brakes to the final corner. Barely made it. and the Jaguar XJ13. Is he right there, or is he just behind me? Just behind me, okay. There's enough space though. I didn't want to push him out of the truck. That wouldn't be fair. Okay, 3 laps to go and just one more car to pass, and that's the Ford GT40. Is dropping down quite quickly. I guess they cannot drop off, right? Two and a half seconds. Differences are quite big. Too wide at that first corner. Double left-hander, and I come out of it in the first place. But I was the inside, so I had the advantage. Ain't over till it's over. And that was quite a big mistake on the corkscrew. Seconds just in one corner. Final lap, and I'm still P2. Sure how that happened, that I didn't brake in time for the corkscrew corner. Doesn't matter, but unfortunately I think I lost the clean race bonus. That was race 8 out of 9. It wasn't a clean race, it wasn't a clean win, but it is a win. And now, finally, the final race of the nostalgic 1979 series. Back to Europe, to Spain, Barcelona circuit, Catalunya. That's definitely the last race I'm doing today. It's been 2 hours long session. That's probably another 10 minutes for that race. Let's do it. Headed in the wrong gear, headed in the first one and the third one. Lock the wheels. Quite easy to do without ABS. Quite busy here. I'll let them drive. There'll be plenty of space and time to overtake them here on the straight. Good acceleration of this car, but I got locked here. Or boxed, I should have said. I got boxed. Quite quickly from P16. 5 laps to go. And 3 more cars to overtake. And I'm not sure what this one's doing here on P3, because that's quite a slow Ferrari. Seconds to the first one and around 5.5 seconds to the second one. so glad this car only has 4 gears. It's not much shifting, luckily, to do that. I think at least one of these cars in front is Ferrari, possibly both. Little lock there. Wow, what did he do? Oh, that was Ford actually, I think. Oh, no, maybe it was Ferrari, I don't know. But he's out. Already 4 seconds down. And just 1 second with the Ferrari in front. Messed up the braking there. He didn't lock the wheels, but wasn't braking strong enough. Or maybe I just started braking a bit too late. Oh. But he will go wider in the exit corner. Oh, he's going to... yeah. Oh, he kept it on the truck. Amazing. I was pretty sure he would go out. He went really shallow into the corner. Slipstream on the inside to the next corner. I messed up braking last time. How is it that he can brake so late and still stop? I would push the brake pedal a bit stronger, I would lock the wheels. Trying to be really hard to overtake him. At least I have inside now and I'm in front. I'm lap 5 out of 6. But it's not over yet. I gained some advantage over him. Seconds and he's quicker on straight. He's catching up really quickly. Final lap, I just need to keep it in the first. seconds, I gain a little bit in the corners. Driving for the fastest lap at the moment, at least. All the truck I have here available for me. Still around 1.7-1.8 seconds. Final chicane and then the final right-hander. And that should be win, with just above 2 seconds advantage. Here we go. And the fastest lap. And that was the last race of nostalgic 1979, race 9 out of 9. And I'm glad, because it was quite a long series. It was a really cool series. Very raw. No helps. Traditional H stick, shift there, clutch, brake, accelerator, or three pedals. No paddles at all. Really fun to drive. But it was 2 hours and 11 minutes and all gold, and that's enough. I'm curious what's going to be next. I think that Lamborghini Cup. And then, once I'm done with that, I think all the others left here. Actually, I'm curious about this one. That has a round wheel, so that will be driven with the Dream. So this one and this one. And then I'll be switching to a GT wheel rather than the round. Not sure about this series. I have to check the scars. I don't have many. I actually have only 3. 2 of them are really quick, though. Actually, all 3 are really quick. Bugatti and 2 Tomahawk. But I want more. I need 4 more, just to have a different car for every truck. That would be cool. Perfect. Thank you very much all for watching. I'll see you next time, and have a good evening. See you.